Welcome students. In science class, today my topic is sorting materials into groups. We see variety of objects everywhere around us. In school, at home, in parks, in gardens, everywhere. All these objects are of different shape, size, colors, and their uses are different. Depending on the uses of the objects, it may be made up of single material or different materials. Before that, let me explain you the difference between object and the material. Material can make an object, but object cannot make a material. If you want to understand this line clearly, I will give you one best example. Take one plastic sheet, and from that plastic sheet, make items like beaker, toys, container, plastic scale, etc. So whatever items you are making are objects, and the sheet, plastic sheet which you are using, it is a material. So for what purpose objects are to be used, according to that we choose material. For that I will give you one example. If you want to hold water in beaker. At the time, why you are taking beaker only? Why you can't take a piece of cloth? You know that in a piece of cloth, water can't be held. It will drain off from that piece of cloth. So for that purpose, we need beaker only. So for this, for what purpose objects are to be used, according to that we choose materials. Before that, we have to learn some properties of the material like appearance, hardness, solubility, visibility. First, I will take appearance. You see, wood is different from iron. Iron is different from aluminium. Aluminium is different from copper. Likewise, so many different items are different from each other. Take aluminium foil. If you see the aluminium foil, it is lustrous, means they give shine. They are the shiny material. On the other hand, if you take wood don't give you shine, they are non-lustrous. If you take chalk, if you take paper, if you take cloth, all these are non-lustrous objects. They don't give shine, they are non-lustrous objects. On the basis of this also, now you can sort out some materials that they are lustrous, they are non-lustrous. Other property, that is the hardness. Take some material, some soft material, and try to compress it in your hand. It will be easily compressed. So you can say that they are the soft material. You can take the example of soft toys. If you take toy and if you try to compress it, it will be easily compressed. On the other hand, if you take prism, yeah stone, yeah wood, any item made up of wood, and try to compress it, it won't be compressed. So they are non-compressible objects. This is another property. Iron, metals, all these are non-compressible. Another property of the objects, on that basis also, you can differentiate that these objects will be of this kind, this object will be of this kind, that is the solubility. Take sugar and salt and put it in a beaker filled with water. It will be dissolved. After some time, if you will see that sugar and salt will be dissolved completely in that water. And in another beaker, you put some sand and try to dissolve that sand in water. It won't be dissolved. So they are not soluble. They are insoluble in water. So substances which are dissolved in water, they are soluble. And substances which are not dissolved in water, they are insoluble substance. You can take the oil also. Put the oil in that water. You will see that two different layers. Oil will float on the surface of the water, and water you will see down, because that this happens because the density of both that oil and water are different. That is the another topic. What is the density? In that same way, you keep leaf or a flower on a water surface. It will float. It won't sink down. You take stone and put it in a beaker. It will sink down in that water. On this basis also, you can sort out some materials. Some materials will float on the surface of the water. Some objects will float on the surface of the water. Some will sink down. On the basis of this also, now you can sort out that which objects or which materials will be, which objects or which materials are floating and which will sink down. Another property of the material, that is the visibility. In that, three things you have to keep in your mind: that objects may be transparent, may be translucent, or may be opaque. For the transparent object, take clear glass of your window. In your house, a window is there. So try to see through that window. Whatever view is there outside of your house, it is seen clearly. So that type of the glass through which you can see the clear object, you can see the things clearly, that type of the objects or that type of the things are known as the transparent objects, opaque objects. Take one wooden sheet and try to see what is lying behind that wooden sheet. You won't be able to see clearly, or you it is not visible at all. So that type of the things through which the things cannot be seen at all are known as the opaque objects. Now comes the translucent. For that, I have to give you one example. Take one butter paper and put a palm, put a palm or your hand behind that butter paper. You can see somewhat figure of your palm, but it is not seen clearly. That type of the objects through which only that partial view is possible but can't be seen clearly, that type of the objects are known as the translucent objects. So now, on the basis of this hardness, solubility, visibility, and some objects float on the surface of the water, now we can sort out. Now it becomes easier for us. We can easily categorize, we can easily differentiate, or we can easily sort out the objects on the basis of these properties. Further, we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.